Hi everyone. Today in this video, let us discuss about the hydroxyzine, how it acts as an antihistamine. Hydroxyzine is one of the antihistamine that is having the wide clinical uses, and this drug can be used in the condition of pruritus, which produce some itching on the skin, and it can also be used in the treatment of urticaria, where it produces skin rashes, and particularly this condition can be observed due to any food or allergic substance. And interestingly, this drug is also producing some sedation, so it can be used as a sedative. And this drug is going to cross the blood-brain barrier, so it can produce some sedation. And that's why it is a first-generation antihistamine. And this drug can also decrease the anxiety, so it can be used as an anxiolytic in the treatment of GAD, generalized anxiety disorder. And apart from this, hydroxyzine is also having some antiemetic property. In this way, this drug acts as an antihistamine, but it is having so many clinical uses. So today in this video, let us see how this drug is going to act and what are the side effects and pharmacokinetic properties of this drug. So first of all, let us see the structure of the hydroxyzine. So this is the structure, and here you can observe one of the heterocyclic ring system. This is a six-member ring system with two nitrogens. This is nothing but the piperazine. Piperazine is a saturated form of the pyrazine. So this is the piperazine ring system is present in the hydroxyzine. That's why hydroxyzine chemically belongs to the piperazine category. And we can start the numbering here. This is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. At the fourth position, it is having a methyl group which is attached by two phenyl groups. So these are collectively called as diphenyl methanes. So that's why hydroxyzine is also belongs to the another chemical category, diphenyl methanes. So hydroxyzine is a diphenyl methane attached with the piperazine at the fourth position. Now let us see the IUPAC name of this hydroxyzine. Here we have to identify the principal functional group, and OH group alcohol forms a principal functional group which is attached by two carbon chain. So suffix of the name is nothing but the ethanol. Now this ethanol is attached by oxygen, which is attached by again ethyl bridge. So this is going to be attached at the second position by a ethoxy group. So hydroxyzine is having a 2-ethoxy ethanol group. And this ethoxy group is now attached with the piperazine ring system by first position. So this is nothing but the piperazine 1-aryl. And if we expand further attachment, this piperazine is having the methyl group at the fourth position, so we can write it as 4-methyl. And this methyl group is going to be attached with a simple phenyl group as well as a 4-chlorophenyl group, so we can fill in the space 4-chlorophenyl and phenyl. In this way, we can write the IUPAC name of the hydroxyzine. Now, this is the structure of the hydroxyzine, but this hydroxyzine can undergo the metabolism by the cytochrome P450 system. And when it undergoes metabolism, it produces one of the metabolite like this. You can see both structures are somewhat similar with a small difference. At the terminal here, you can observe the carboxylic acid is going to be produced. So simply alcohol is converted to carboxylic acid by oxidation. Now, what is the name of this metabolite? Interestingly, this metabolite is again one of the active drug, and this is nothing but the citrulline. So hydroxyzine gives the one of the active metabolite, which is nothing but the sedation. Sedation is a well-known antihistamine. And here the hydroxyzine is a first generation antihistamine, whereas the sedation is the second generation antihistamine. In this way, hydroxyzine can be converted into sedation, which also acts as an antihistamine. But this is a second generation, so it cannot cross the blood-brain barrier easily, so that it produces less sedation. Whereas hydroxyzine can easily enter into the CNS, thereby it produces sedation. That's why it is used as a sedative as well as anxiolytic. Now let us see the mechanism of action of hydroxyzine. On the different cells like the basophils, monocytes, the histamine H1 receptors are present. Now the histamine, which is going to be released from the mast cells and basophils, can act on the H1 receptor. When it is going to bind to this H1 receptor, these H1 receptors are G protein coupled receptors, which are coupled with the phospholipase C system. This phospholipase C is going to be activated, which then cleaves the phosphatidyl inositol biphosphate into the two components. One of the component is the IP3 inositol triphosphate, and another component is the DAG, diacylglycerol. This diacylglycerol can activate the protein kinase C, which is going to stimulate the entry of the calcium through the specialized calcium channels. Now the calcium can more enter into the cells. Similarly, IP3 can release the intracellular calcium stores. In this way, both IP3 and calcium can increase the intracellular calcium levels. Now, this calcium can act on few of these internal stores, from which the few of the inflammatory mediators like the IL-4 and IL-13 can be released, which can produce many of the inflammatory reactions. And apart from these mediators, the increased calcium can also promote the release of the nitric oxide within the vascular smooth muscle, which results in the vasodilation. In this way, all these mediators can produce few of the symptoms in the patients like the itching, skin rashes, as well as vasodilation. All these symptoms are mainly produced by histamine. Now, the hydroxyzine can act as an antagonist at the H1 receptors. The hydroxyzine can bind to these H1 receptors, thereby it can inhibit the activity of the H1 receptors so that it can antagonize the action of the histamine. In this way, hydroxyzine can prevent the itching, skin rashes, as well as the vasodilatory response, which produce some redness as well as inflammation within the skin. Now, what is the pharmacokinetics of this hydroxyzine? What is the onset of action of this drug? This drug is having an onset of action of around 15 to 30 minutes. That means this drug shows a fast onset of action. And what about the duration of action? This drug is having a duration around 3 to 4 hours. Therefore, this drug is a short-acting antihistamine. That's why this drug should be given frequently, and maximum dose is 4 times daily. What are the side effects? Hydroxyzine is an antihistamine, but it can also act on the cholinergic receptors. Therefore, it produces few other side effects like the dry mouth, blurred vision, constipation. All these side effects are because of the anticholinergic side effects. And particularly, it produces a dry mouth, which can be called as xerostomia. The salivary secretion is going to be decreased, resulting in the dry mouth, which is commonly observed in the patients. Similarly, it can also produce few other central side effects like the dizziness and drowsiness because it can enter into the CNS. These two are the central side effects of the hydroxyzine. And another important one is the prolongation of the QT interval. Hydroxyzine is one of the drugs which can increase the QT interval within the ECG. Therefore, it is proarrhythmic in nature and it can precipitate one of the fatal condition, torsade de pointis. Torsade de pointis is one of a fatal cardiac arrhythmias which should be immediately treated. Otherwise, it can lead to the death of the patient. Now, this hydroxyzine is a proarrhythmic drug which can produce a torsade de pointis. That's why this drug should not be combined with the other drugs which are again proarrhythmic. For example, the class 3 antiarrhythmics like the imidazoline, sotalol can also increase the torsade de pointis. So, these drugs should not be combined with the hydroxyzine. How it is given? This drug is available in the various forms. It is available as a tablet, capsule, as well as solution, which is suitable for the injection, as well as also available as a syrup. In this way, it is available at the multiple formulations, and even it is available at the different doses. The dose may be variable from the 10 to the 100 mg. Commonly, it is available at 50 to 100 mg dose, but it is also available at the 10 mg as well as 25 mg. So, according to the clinical use, the dose can be fixed. And because of short duration of action, this drug can be given 4 times daily. So, that's about the hydroxyzine. Hydroxyzine is a first generation antihistamine, and this drug can be used in the treatment of pruritus, urticaria, as well as it acts as a sedative, anxiolytic, and it also shows some antiemetic properties. This drug belongs to the chemical class of diphenylmethanes as well as the piperazines, and this drug can be converted to cetirizine by liver metabolism. Particularly, hydroxyzine acts as an antihistamine by blocking the H1 receptors, thereby it can decrease the skin rashes, itching, and vasodilatory response. At the same time, this drug can enter into the CNS, thereby it can produce some sedation as well as some antiemetic effect. And this drug produces some anticholinergic side effects like the dry mouth, blurred vision, constipation, and apart from that, it can also produce the drowsiness and dizziness as the central side effects. Increase in the QT interval is one of the important limitations of this drug, which may produce the torsade de pointis. So, this drug should be carefully given with the other drugs which produce the torsade de pointis. So, that's about this hydroxyzine. Hope you have enjoyed this video. If you like this video, please subscribe to our channel. Share this video with your friends. Post your comments in the comment box. Thank you for watching this video.